Hallelujah. Well, happy Easter. Viewers all over the world. That is the language everywhere. Happy Easter. I need to use a language you understand. But today we are going to talk about that revelation. Because the name Jesus is revelation. And the message to you is revelation. When we listen to it, we want to know. Even the faith is made known by divine revelation. And even I'm here today, if you are not looking at me through revelation, you continue to see T.B. Joshua, that's your brother, that have a white hair here. You may be seated, thank you. Hallelujah. Yes, you continue to see, the man you will see is the man you know before, the man you still know, this man, what is he going to say? Okay, let's listen to him. Let's listen to what he's going to say. Well, I see miracle, I see what happened. It's not the man. By revelation, it's not the man. You are not here to see the man. You are here by revelation to see a man called prophet, not a man called T.B. Joshua. T.B. Joshua, hallelujah. T.B. Joshua is your brother. You know him. But there's a man you need to know by revelation. So that is divine nature. Hallelujah. Okay, let's quickly take our look to the book of 1 Corinthians 12, the name Jesus. Hallelujah. The name Jesus. Let's take 1 Corinthians 12. The 1 Corinthians 12, verse 3. It says, therefore, I want you to know that no one who is speaking by the Spirit of God says, Jesus be cursed. And no one can say, Jesus is Lord, except by the help of what? That is revelation. Can I say, except by the help of the Holy Ghost, you can say, Jesus. It means you cannot just wake up and say, Jesus, without being led. Because you hear people say, Jesus, and you say, don't them say, Jesus. You are calling your brother at home. You just say, Jesus. And you, the name Jesus, you to say, Jesus. Without being led by the Spirit, you are calling it. I was watching a game yesterday. I saw a guy named Jesus. When the referee would say, Jesus, Jesus. I said, with Jesus. On the field. That was yesterday. I saw a guy who was playing football, number 7. His name Jesus. I said, I said, this is the name some of our people used to call. And the man cannot help them. That is a human being. But the Jesus of Nazareth can be revealed to you by revelation. You must be led by the Spirit to know that Jesus, not the name of your brother, but name Jesus of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Yes. See. Let's read together again. 1 Corinthians 12. Verse 3. Therefore, I want you to know that no one who is speaking by the Spirit of God says, but if you call the name Jesus by the help of the Spirit, you will not call your brother at home. Now he said, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the help, except by the Holy Ghost, that is Holy Spirit. So it means the name Jesus must be revealed to you, like we used to say here. See my faith bracelets here? I know many of you. See, I know you were looking at my hand when I was raising my hand. Me too. Each time I see you with red bracelets, I say I need to carry my own too. This is my own. But if here I have now, by the time I move a bit, someone will tell me that I have a vision, you give me faith bracelets. That is how they collected my faith bracelet. I have a vision and you give me faith bracelets. I said, which one? They said, this one in your hand. What were you expecting me to say? As a man who is encouraging people to accept salvation, every proper means, I will give you, even though you don't have any revelation. Okay, that is it. So this is the reason why I will put it somewhere, but this one, I'm going to hold it. Whatever revelation you have, you will meet me there. You will meet me there in your revelation. I'm going to hold this one today because I want to have my own anywhere I'm going, just like you. This is how I want to put my own. So when I'm talking to you, revelation you have, you meet me. Revelation will meet revelation. Hallelujah. Yes, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit, by the help of Holy Spirit. What does that mean? Your God is not a human. You can say he came from what? To do what? Because we say happy Easter. What is the meaning of Easter? What do we mean? Whom are we celebrating? Is it your brother or someone you know somewhere? You know, revelation brings conviction. And conviction brings re-movement. When we say re-movement, we step. Power step. We say re-movement, I'm Christian. You talk of power. It's not just, you can't separate Christian from power. Christianity, you can't separate them from power. Your children, they are part of your blessing. If one is faulty, all is faulty. If one is in pain, all in pain. If one is bad, all bad. There is no shortcut. Life is a marathon, not a sprint. Life is a marathon, not war, not a sprint, no shortcuts. We want to use a shortcut. You see the war today, we say happy Easter, where you see many general managers, these are the people that cannot manage their home. Many general managers cannot manage their home. Many head of prostator cannot manage their home and their general manager. How would they manage that? Many want to own their company and they cannot keep their own car clean. Ordinary car, they cannot keep it clean, but they want to own their own company. What kind of company you expecting from people like that? Many want to get married, that's not about, because of their age, but they cannot keep their kids, their pet, at home. They cannot manage their pet at home, but they want to get married because of their age. This is what turned the whole world upside down today. You that cannot keep your car clean.
You want to own your own company, your own car. You cannot keep it clean. But you want to have your own company. You cannot manage your home, but you are the head of big and different companies, MD of the companies. What do you expect from such company? Charity begin at home. Happy Easter. Jesus was able to manage his team. That is why today we have a pay supreme price. We are here today to celebrate. Jesus does not want any one of us to end up our days saying, I should have been, I would have been, I could have been. Happy Easter. Tell your neighbor, Jesus does not want us to end our days saying, I could have been, I should have been, I would have been. Happy Easter. I want to leave you so that you have time to go and celebrate, but you know what you want to celebrate now. We are here today, your kid at home, your children at home, you can't say let us go. They will tell you, fuck you. What are you celebrating? But you are managing other children, you are the leader of other children, you are the controller of other children, instructor of other children, commander of other children. Jesus does not want us to succeed financially and lose our kids, our children, to drug, and lose our children to militant, and lose our children to the war. Pick that way and take it home. Before you begin to celebrate, go and put your home in order. We want to use shortcuts. Life is a marathon. You want to be God's person. Follow his process. Karata. Nothing good happens without discipline. Nothing good happens without what?
Discipline.
This is why Jesus is trying to build karata now. So that when you get to the place of your destiny, you will not crash and explode and lose it all. Many lose it all today. You see the war go up and lose it up. Greatness, lose it up. Popularity, you see fame, lose it up. Because we are not follow process. We are talking of dividend of Easter. What is Easter? He went for you to make you fit, to make you qualify, to make you a friend of God, to make you dine and wine with God. You can still restate your way and put things right. Those of you that know, you even the little home you have, you cannot manage it, but you are the head of companies. You can still look back, because you will soon lose it all. Those of us that you believe you have succeeded, you are well known, you have money, you have influence, if you share influence and you have lost your kids, your children to drug, to militant, to the war, you can still look back. It's not too late to carry them along. What is right is right. What is not right is not right. Nothing good happens without discipline. Take it back in. I say we look at all our weakness, our faults, our pitiful fault, and say, it is not going to happen to me. What happened to others? What happened in the name of God is not about your weakness, is not about your pitfall, is not about your fault. It is about what Jesus achieved, did for us. He made you qualify. Because of my weakness, it cannot happen to me. Because of my fault, it cannot happen to me. No. It can happen to you. In the name of Jesus. I say it can happen to you. In the name of Jesus. If Satan wants to rob you your blessing, he will say to you, because of your weakness. He will immediately remind you of your weakness, your fault. And when that begins to come in your heart, you know this is the work of Satan. For you to be here today and join us to celebrate Easter, God prepared you. Okay. Tell you, God prepared me in advance. Tell your neighbor again, for me to be here today, God prepared me in advance before putting me in the life, in the fire of life. You know, you came from home, many of you through flight, you know, it's fire of life, fly on the air, human being pilots you, the person piloting may not be a Christian, may be a drunkard, may be a smoker, but that is fire of life. If God has not prepared you in advance, you will not be able to escape through. he prepared me in advance before putting me inside the aircraft, inside the trail, inside the vehicle. Here. He prepared you in advance before putting you in the fire of life. That would have been very easy for your enemy to get you. If God has not prepared you, if God had not prepared you, that would have been very easy for your enemy to get you. Very, very easy for your enemy to get you. From one flight to stopover, sleeping, join another flight, bar, enter, car. Oh my God. He had prepared you in advance before putting you. Say, he had prepared me in advance before putting me in the fire of life. So I can leave you to celebrate your Easter. So you can say to your neighbor, Happy Easter. All what you have been saying before now, it's like you are celebrating your brother. Your brother called Jesus somewhere, but Jesus of Nazareth must build character so that when you get to the place of your destiny, you will not crash. Now, here is character. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Answer me.
Happy Easter.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to leave you, and I begin to think about it. You know, I told you that the world become part of us by meditation. The word of God become part of you by what? See, sometimes when I'm alone, I continue to fire on. When I told you I watched a game yesterday, football. I have time, it's not a sin. I just sit and I was watching. While this one was in my hand, I saw that number 7. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I said, which Jesus are you calling? I said, Jesus, 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 Jesus. It was about to score. They said, Jesus, you can say, go, go. I said, this one is not Jesus, you cannot score. Hallelujah. So, and I want to leave you. And can I hear your lesson and the message you are taking home this Easter? And come on, someone there. Here, let me hear the message you are taking home. What have you learned? Okay, come on. The serious one you must talk about. Don't tell us history or story. I want you to talk about it. Jesus wants us to succeed.
Jesus wants us to succeed before we destroy ourselves. If truly we don't know him well, by protecting us, giving us character so that we won't destroy ourselves by leaving our children to go astray.
Happy Easter, my brother. Thank you. I will soon leave you so that you can go and eat your jollof rice. Someone there? Tell me about your children now. Jesus does not want you to succeed and lose your key.
Yes.
Jesus
does not want me to succeed and lose my kids. So thereby, I must work on my character and my children. I must work on their spiritual life so
You can see me, I'm drawn very close to you.
Yes.
But I like what you are saying.
Yes, Daddy.
Jesus does not want you to succeed and lose your key to draw.
Yes, sir.
He does not want you to succeed financially and lose your key to militant.
Yes, sir.
He does not want you to succeed and lose your key to the world.
Yes, sir.
What do you want to say about that?
Yes,
the one at home.
I, by the grace of God, I'm teaching them the way of God because I want them to grow in
and
the fear.
And they listen to you.
Yes, Daddy, by the grace of God.
Your daughter listens to you.
Yes, Daddy, by the grace of God.
The grace of God is grace of God. Nowadays, when you hear Christians that say, by the grace of God, I'll get there, now lie. Allah is saying, is expressing her doubts. When they see a man that says, by the grace I will get there, he's expressing doubts. What kind of grace? Grace is not a mango. Okay, we help you. Now you know the message, now you have to go back. You have job to do. Message to that daughter. Okay?
Starting.
You have to go back and work on her.
Studying.
Okay? If not, you may likely lose it all. That is the blessing you have.
Thank you.
Hey, come on. Happy Easter. Give it to her.
Jesus does not want me to succeed because his suffering on the Calvary should not be in vain upon my life and my family.
It's like all your heart is your pandeyam. See that, Baba? Thank you very much. I know you want them to see you at home. Somebody say, hey, I'll see my mom. I know that. Uh-huh. Give it to the sister.
When I had a message saying Jesus does not want me to succeed because he wants to prepare me or prepare my children for my future, This made me to remember a dream I had some time ago.
You listen to what, before you go further, you listen to what is the way he turned it now. He say it's like a God is building character. That is why our success is delayed. So because God will not allow you to just get that success without character. And if you don't have character and you succeed, you may likely lose it all. Clap for her. So for you now to be thinking that God does not answer my prayer, God does not answer my prayer. No, who tell you God does not answer your prayer? He loves you. It's busy building character. Because if you succeed without right character, one will likely lose it all. There is nothing you can keep for a while, for long, without character. I don't know. Because I have said, nothing good happens without discipline.
So, I had a dream some time ago, and I don't know the meaning of that dream. Just when this message came, the message reminded me of the dream I had some time ago. When in that dream, there was a very big flood that is packing everything, cars, building, houses, everything. Everybody was running, and when I turned back, I saw that everything was cleared. Cars, trees, houses, everything was clear. I was the only one that was left in that dream. Then when I heard a voice, I looked up, I saw somebody was hanged on the air. And he said, look, vanity upon vanity.
All is vanity.
It's a vanity upon vanity. I was so scared in that dream, then I woke up. When I woke up, I thought the world was coming to an end. In fact, nobody would tell me that. Maybe the world will live for the next day or something. I believe maybe before that evening.
Thank you. You have been great to talk for 2 to 3 minutes. Okay, thank you. I think we have done here. Okay, give it to Baba here. Baba is there. Okay.
I think the message I will take home is that nothing good happened without discipline.
Yes, thank you.
All challenges human being has is part of discipline. You cannot have salvation
without
discipline.
Clap for him, clap for him. Clap for him. You listen to that? It's not possible to have salvation without discipline. If you have that salvation, you lose it all. No salvation without discipline. Nothing good happen without discipline. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Okay, give it to give it to our brother there. Okay? Okay. After her.
Man of God. Mm-hmm. Invariably, he's telling us that without salvation, you looking for salvation, trying to earn it, because everything you earn, it's only by the time you agree with yourself that this is what I can do. That money is good, but not just getting money from all angles. There are money that you can say without process, and it comes to you, it's actually not going to help you. That money is good, but with process.
Thank you. Clap for him. You listen to that? So it is time now to begin to think inwardly. Now it's like the message has answered our question. There are many of us here that are heading a company. Many of us here that own their own company. There are many MD, general manager here. And you can see, look back, even your little house, you cannot manage them. And are you talking of those of us that have company? Your car, your house, one can see that this is a general manager. This is own company, this is owner of the companies. I mean, there are many marriages today, so much tension. Because God's time is the best. So take the lesson. We have many also here that you are blessed, you have money, you have enough. Where are your children? Many of our children, we have lost them to the war. Drug. If you don't quickly run to God and look back, seek for solution for these children, you may likely lose it all. The wealth, the influence may likely disappear. Like I have said, Jesus does not want us to end our days saying, I could have been, I should have been, I would have been. I've done enough here. Let me turn to these people here. Because, who has something to... Okay, yes. Let's hear from you.
I've learned that before you believe, you must get your own revelation. You must believe in God through the Holy Spirit to get revelation. There's nothing that you can become an MD without carrying your children along. You must always carry your children
along.
Carry them along. Yes.
You listen to that? They are part and parcel. They are integral part of you. On the last day, God, our Lord Jesus, will ask you, where are they? Where are they? Will you tell Jesus, I have lost them to the drug? Will you tell Jesus, I have lost them to militants? Will you tell Jesus, I have lost them to the war? Question mark. Thank you. Any other? Okay, my brother here.
I've learned that what I'm taking home is nothing could happen without the process, and I've learned that life is a marathon, not a sprint, and God can use any situation to discipline us. So we must value the process.
Thank you. Clap for him. You listen to that? Our brother is taking us through the process that if you want to become God's person, you must follow his process. Tell your neighbor, if you want to become God's person, you must follow his process. Again and again. Any question there? Okay. What message are you taking home? What you hear from people? Okay. The sister here. After sister, we go to the others. You agree with me why many of you are still going through what you are going through. Because God is busy building character. Because if that's no character, whatever you achieve, you may likely lose it all. Tell your neighbor, I know why I'm going through what I'm going through. God is busy building character. Yes, that character will help you when you are at the place of your destiny. It will help you to sustain, to stand the challenges of time. Say, my business is not going well. Why my business is like this? Why am I not have job? What's wrong? I'm sick and I'm a Christian. Ask God. Listen, it may be God is busy building character. That character will sustain you, will help you. That is why there is a stop. Take your pen. God is trying to build character. Say after me, God is trying to build character. Now, I can hear you. That now should be in a capital form. Capital N, capital O, capital W. God is busy. God is trying to build character. Now! If you don't get that character now, whatever you achieve, you likely lose it. Character is a tonic. Character is the oil in the lamp. Whatever you achieve is that flame, the light that is burning. But the oil in the lamp is character. And if there is no oil in the lamp, what will happen to the lamp? It will. Your business will off. One business will off. One thing will off. One influence will off. One, the glory will off. Popularity will off. You say, where is this man? They can't hear him again. The oil is dry. That is character. Are you with me? Oil in the lamp is character. The lamp light is what? Proceed. Proceed could be money, fame, influence, popularity, this, that, president, minister, senate, rich, that is proceed. But the oil inside the lamb is character. And when the oil dry, all the proceed is what? Will soon.
When you get home, you need lamb. If I were you, just put lamb on your altar. I know you have everything you need. The electricity is there, but electricity apart. Put lamb on your table. It's a symbol that the light there, they are a proceed. The oil inside the lamb, a karata. Anytime you fail to put oil and it's dry, you see the light off. That is your life. When you put lamb on your altar, it's a symbol of you. You, you is that lamb. If you look at my altar, my prayer room, you see lamp there. But there's light, there's electricity. But people say, why that lamp? Yes, that is a symbol. And when the lamp, when the oil is gradually drying, you see the kind of dim light, which you will not be able to identify anything with that dim light. This is the life of many of us today. Your process is not enough. It's causing you trouble. Where you are supposed to give home ₦1 million, ₦1 million, you are given ₦5,000. What is not done well is not done at all. They have given you a name. You don't know what to do again because what you have is not enough. It's no longer enough because the oil is drying. Are you there? Let's hear from our sister, huh?
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
What I learned today is that there's no shortcut in life. Mm-hmm. That as we being a work of art in God's hand, we must wait patiently and follow his process so that whatsoever we will receive in life will stand a test of time. Emmanuel.
You listen to that? You see, you are a work of art. Thank you. You know, you take a pen, you are taking a picture, try to draw some object. Yeah, you are, tell your neighbor, I'm a work of art. I can hear you. Again and again. If you want to be a person of God, you must follow his process. Thank you. Let's.
Good morning, church. Yeah, what I'm taking back home with me, I have learned here that we cannot separate Christianity from power. The revelation I got here for me is that wisdom is to see, but also seeing is power from God, but also seeing is responsibility, which means through the power of God we can change the situation.
My brother must like power. Power, my brother like power. Clap my brother. You can see in his statement, he natural power up to 4 times. That is, oh my God, you listen to that. That is, revelation bring conviction. And conviction bring re-movement. Re-movement, power step. Okay, you understand that? Power step. Step with intent and purpose. Clap for my brother. Thank you very much. So, me, with this, you can know if you are born again. You can know. The question, what kind of Christian you want to be? Ask your neighbor. I can't hear you. Because there are many Christians without power of Holy Ghost. Christian with power of Holy Ghost. Because to be a Christian, you must be led by the Holy Ghost. And many Christians today are not led by the Holy Ghost. That's why I'm asking you, what kind of Christian you want to be? What kind of leader you want to be? Leader with purpose. Leader with different. What kind of leader you want to be? So when we talk of power as a Christian, you need to ask, what kind of Christian you want to be? kind of Christian? Because the Bible says in that 1 Corinthians 12:3, it says no one can say Jesus is Lord without the help of Holy Ghost. That is Christian. No one can be a Christian without the help of Holy Ghost. Ask the Lord, what kind of Christian you want to be? What kind of leader you want to be? That is a question for you to answer. Thank you, our brother. So, next question. No, I know many of you say question. You know how many? We are just 0.5% of the people that are anchored with humanity. It's the most watched channel in the world right now. As we are talking right now, is it either secular channel, religious channel, or whatever. Right now is the most watched channel in the world. So we must carry people at home. We must carry people out there, our viewer along. This helping them. Many children, their family, they are together watching. With this question of God does not want to, want you to succeed financially and lose your key to draw. Many a family will be query themselves now. Many women, many father will say, look, can you hear what they are saying now? Can you hear? You better stop drug. You are disgracing. Hear what they are saying. This help people at home.
Good morning, church. The lesson I learned today I will take home is about character and self-discipline. We are not rushed to have big things while we cannot manage small things. Man of God talked about not being able to clean a small car, but you want to run a fleet of Benz.
Clap for my brother. You listen to that? Yes. You want to have your own company. Fleet of companies. And you cannot keep your car clean. Every car in the garage, you'll be very surprised to see many owner of the companies. If you open their garage, they cannot do anything. They have house maid, house boy, everybody. Money cannot do anything. What are you talking about? You have to lead by example. If not, you will lose it all. I like that. We have many of us here that this message is talking to. You own companies, not one, not two, not three companies. In a week, you may not even go to any of these companies because you have money to employ people to do the job for you. For how long will you continue this? Can money run a wrong company? Your presence is a good thing to your workers. Your presence is good thing to your worker and to your follower. They want to know how you become what you are. They want to know how you talk. They want to know how you move. They want to know how you give instruction. They want to know how you address people. They want to know how you relate with people. That will give them hope for future. But hardly your staff, your worker, hardly see you one day. They don't know their boss. You live in heaven. Okay, let's hear from our brother.
Good morning, church. The word that I'm carrying with you home is that the word of God become part of us through meditation.
Yes.
The more you meditate, the more you hear the voice of the Lord, and the more you become the person of the Lord and follow his processes.
Clap for him. You listen to that? Meditation seems to be first. Meditation brings revelation. Revelation brings conviction. And conviction brings re-moment. Can I say process? You say, if you want to be God person, you must follow his process. Meditation. What am I talking about now? Begin to meditate. And turn it over and over in your heart. That is to continuation. Turn it over and over and over and over. Revelation comes. And that revelation will give conviction and lead you to real moment. Yes. Okay. After that, you go straight to the back there. Here, okay? Thank you.
Praise
and
the
I,
Lord.
And I want to say something. When you get home today, your family, your husband, your wife will fight you that you are not asked a question. I know. That is the Spirit of God is telling me that many people should be ready for fights. Even your son, your daughter, you know, some of your daughter and your son say, Daddy, how many times I call you? Daddy will say, 3 times. Are you sure you are in the synagogue? Daddy will say, why? Why are you asking me this question? Does it mean you cannot answer any of this question?
Yes. The message I'm taking home is that...
Speak louder.
The message I'm taking home is that life is a marathon and not a speed, and that discipline plays an important role in our lives.
Can you tell me how does this affect you?
Me?
Because you're a young man.
Yes, sir.
I know you are talking about your experience. It's laughing. Look, people want to learn. We are hungry for the knowledge. This is Easter. Hungry for the knowledge. It's like this thing actually affects you in one way or the other. Life is marathon.
I like the speed. Like, if I should say about myself, like, sometimes...
How does the message you are giving us affect your
me,
mind?
Yeah, it affected me in this part that most of us want to be successful so fast. Using the shortcut.
Thank you. Clap for him.
Yes.
You listen to that? Listen to that. It's a young man, so I know. You see, we want to make a shortcut, forgetting that life is marathon, not just a sprint. Shortcut. Shortcut means we are not waiting for God to build character. And we don't know, if you don't wait for God to build this character in you, by the time you get to your place of destiny, what happened? Something will crash, explode, and we likely lose all. This is what has happened today. This is what has happened all over the world. Character, like I have said, is oil in the lamp. When there's no oil in the lamp, what happened to the light? That is just it. That is just you. So you can tell me, you now with this message, now you know why you are going through what you are going through. Not that it is never proper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. Tell your neighbor. It is never proper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. Again,
I say, God, I need car, I need to pay my debt. But after prayer, no, nothing, the prayer seems not to answer. Now I now say, I have no faith. No. God is busy build character. God knows if I give you what you want, immediately, something will crash and will likely lose it all. Tell your neighbor, it is never proper. Base faith on our improvement after prayer. Again, yes, because you always base faith on your improvement. Once you pray and no answer, you say, I have no faith. Because of that, you will not pray again. Some will say, I have no faith. I have no faith. That is why you stop moving to church. I have no faith. That's why you refuse to pray. You pray, you say, oh Lord, I want to pass my examination. But when the result came, you find that there's some holdback, setback, or the result failure. Don't base your prayer on improvement after prayer. Because the reason why you are not have your result is God is holding you a little back. He wants to build character. When the character comes, you can stand for the greatness that is coming. What you need, what you are asking from God, is not all that important now. The result of your prayer is not all that important now, but more important tomorrow. Tell your neighbor again. The result of my prayer now is not all that important now, but more important tomorrow. That is what you are going to receive today after prayer from God. It's important, but more important tomorrow. You need it in a difficult time, in a trial time. You need those resolve. So please, God is trying to build character. Listen to that. God is trying to do what? So when you get to the place of your destiny, you will not crash and explode and lose it all. Okay, next. Thank you, brother. Thank you. The brother that gave us his own experience, thank you. That's my friend. Thank you. Okay, let's hear. Give it to them.
Thank you, Jesus, for revealing this revelation to me.
I hope you enjoy your Easter.
Yes.
In this way, you enjoy it.
Yes.
This one is better than rice.
Yes.
It's better than the jollof rice.
Yes.
It's better than padded yam.
Yes.
It's better than vegetable.
Yes.
Salad.
Yes.
Thank you. This is manna from heaven.
Yes.
So which is different from any manna you are waiting for? Well, yeah, this is manna from heaven. Okay, let's hear from our mom.
I just want to thank God for revealing this revelation to me. Because what I was going through, I didn't know that God was disciplining me. My life was in a mess, and I just thought, what is going on in my life? Because my first time of coming here in this church, it was not for the salvation of my soul. It was all about, I wanted business, making money. But myself, I didn't have the character. Even the way I used to talk to people, it was not representing that I'm a Christian. So I just want to thank God for this revelation that God is building my character and is God's processing.
Clap for my mom. Good. You listen to that. My mom now realized that nothing good happened without discipline. And what gives us discipline? God's character. There is nothing can discipline or apart from God's character. It's God's character that brings discipline. The proceed of God's character is discipline. Nothing good happens without what? Without discipline. Salvation cannot come without discipline. Even the blessing we are waiting for, even the healing we are waiting for now. If you are healed without discipline, you will likely lose it. If you are blessed without discipline, you will likely lose it. It crash. If you are blessed without discipline, it crash. And at the time it will crash, at the time you need it most, that blessing. Okay, so we have just 2 minutes more. Okay, come on, give it to my brother here. Yeah? 2 minutes more. Mm-hmm.
Emmanuel, what I've learned today is that, yes, God has provided for all our needs, but we are the cause of the delay because we don't want to submit to God's discipline process.
Clap for my brother. That is, we are the cause of delay. Because we don't want to submit. We just want something from God, but we are not ready to submit. We are not ready for salvation. Submission is salvation. We are not ready for salvation. So we are the cause of delay. Are you ready?
Yes.
So listen to my brother say, we are the cause of delay. Are you ready?
Yes.
You stop delaying.
Yes.
Talk now.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. I hope you have your pen writing this. Basically, what I said last now, that it is never proper to base our faith. To base faith, don't put your faith, you have no faith. It's God's faith. Blasphemy. It is never proper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. Write it down. It is never proper. To base faith, it is never proper to base faith on our improvement after prayer. Whatever you say, Jesus, Jesus, and you are not answered, that does not mean you don't have faith. God may busy building character. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. You promise you will not collect my faith baseless. Okay, I'll wait. Okay, it is time now. Hallelujah. Well, it's like I cannot trust you. I really love you. I'll put it in my pocket. You soon come with your revelation.